All right, next we do have Lars Hansen. And I would like to say something in all sincerity, that we're really grateful to have Lars and Cynthia here. They've been in Honesdale and Wayne County since 2009, when they opened the shop right across the street. How convenient. They opened the shop right across the street, the Hansen Gallery in Decorum. It's a wonderful, wonderful place. We really appreciate the fact that they have been here. You know, sometimes when you move in from out of town into a fairly closely knit small town, whether it's Honesdale or wherever it is in the country, you know, sometimes it's difficult to become assimilated into the town. Probably half of the people in the audience know exactly what I'm talking about. But the Hansons have truly been assimilated very quickly, and we really appreciate everything that they have done for the community. Thank you very much. I mean that. Now I want to introduce Lars. He has quite a reputation in the past with music and decorations and so on, but I just want to let you know, in trying to introduce different people here, I sort of had to be a dentist and pull teeth to get information. It's a little communique I had with Lars a couple of days ago. Lars, by the way, what are your acts going to be? Thanks. Bob. Well, 2 days later, Lars replied, "Hi, Bob. First, I sit down wearing a mask and listen to a record player." "Second, I do a little stand-up wearing a mask, play guitar, and sing a song. Is that helpful?" I replied, "Lars, I can make something out of number two. Number one doesn't give me much to go on. Are you going to be Marcel Marceau? Or what? I promise not to give it away." This morning at 7:44.
Don't tell.
"Hi, Bob. Okay, here's what I'm doing. I have some props placed on stage."
Props?
"What a lovely prop you are too, my dear. A fence, a saddle, a cowboy boots, spurs?" "No, no spurs. Yippee-yay-yay-yay. I come in, put on a formula, okay. Introduce us as Lars Hansen and his special guest, Cynthia Hansen." Ladies and gentlemen, the Hansen Queen.
And when that sheriff said, "I'm sending you to jail," while
I usually don't need a mic. How old are you, Trigger?